has been given, the light has been set on a hill. God's word in his truth may be trusted by all who surrender their will. To order the chaos of darkness, give hope in the midst of despair. To make of our life new creations, and lighten the burdens we bear. A lamp for our steps has been given, a light has been set on a hill. God's word in his truth may be trusted by all who surrender their will.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: wedding anniversary blessings for Hector and Virginia Dias, Wilfred and Lily Dias, John and Tecla Di Bello, birthday blessings for Vanessa Cornelio, for peace of mind of Ryan and to overcome financial difficulties, for the souls of Victor Carrasco, Almeida, Parsons, Berkeleys, Fernandez and the Tates families, Martha and Bertha Dias, Gerard D'Souza, Henry Fernandez, Brendan Fernandez and Valley Matthews, Reginaldo Miguel Vaz, Virginia and Gangadhar Savant, and Bella Pinto. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather around the Eucharistic table, let us thank and praise the Lord for his blessings, and seek pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who through the regenerating power of baptism have been pleased to confer on us heavenly life, grant, we pray, that those you render capable of immortality by justifying them may by your guidance attain the fullness of glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Paul came also to Derbe and to Lystra. A disciple was there named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. He was well spoken of by the brothers at Lystra and Iconium. Paul wanted Timothy to accompany him, and he took him and circumcised him because of the Jews who were in those places, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they went on their way through the cities, they delivered to them for observance the decisions that had been reached by the apostles and elders who were in Jerusalem. So the churches were strengthened in the faith, and they increased in numbers daily. And they went through the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And when they had come up to Mysa, they attempted to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So passing by Mysa, they went down to Tros, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. A man of Macedonia was standing there, urging him and saying, come over to Macedonia and help us. And when Paul had seen the vision, immediately we sought to go on into Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, cry out with joy to the Lord all the earth. Kindly listen to the tune.
Cry out with joy to the Lord all the earth. Cry out with joy to the Lord all the earth. Cry out with joy to the Lord all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him singing for joy. Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Know that he, the Lord, is Lord. He made us, we belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Alleluia. Alleluia. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, if the world hates you, know that it has hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love you as its own. But because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is no greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours. But all these things they will do to you on account of my name, because they do not know him who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord makes it very clear to his disciples that if anyone were to follow him, then they would surely be persecuted, they would have to face challenges, because he himself has gone through persecution and has even been challenged by people of the world. Where does that leave us? In these times, there can be opposition of various sorts, sometimes very overtly, sometimes not very evident. But we must never lose hope in God, never lose hope in Christ, because it is in his name that we do everything that his Father wills us to do. Whether it is reaching out to people in love, whether it is helping people in our own family or to the community that we belong to, whenever we face opposition, we must always receive the strength from the fact that our Lord himself has been persecuted and has gone through challenges. It is not easy to be a disciple of the Lord in the world, but drawn to this challenge, we must be nourished by the fact that God takes care of us as his disciples, and even through these challenges, we experience his presence always. Amen.
We ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. O Father, we are yours. We are yours. Yours as we stand at the table, you said. Yours as we eat the bread, our hearts can't we are the signs of your life with us here
Take our breath, we ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. O Father, we are yours. We are yours.
Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands and
praise the glory of his name for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Holy, holy,
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself holy to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your comforting words in our liturgy today. As we surrender ourselves to your will, we pray that you may bring healing to our lives and to the world. We lift up to you all our pain, our worry, our anxieties, our struggles. We place into your hands all those who are vulnerable, those who are sick and suffering, those who are depressed. Lord, we know that your eternal word resides forever in our hearts. And as we pray for one another, we also lift up to you expectant mothers looking forward to the birth of a child in their lives. We pray for couples who are struggling in their relationship. We pray for those struggling with their work. We know, Lord, that there are many people around us who are not even receiving a healthy meal each day. Lord, through these experiences, we surrender ourselves into your hands and we ask you to bring healing and comfort to all those who seek your help in the world. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace and celebrate the gospel with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say
rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say.